For the most part, those who readily judge and condemn are those who love to find fault and to condemn rather than to reprove and correct. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, these days in the Gospels, we are hearing about the Sermon on the Mount. The Sermon on the Mount contains the essence of Jesus' teaching. It gives the fundamental statements for our life in accordance with the law of God and guidelines for our relationship with our fellow humans. According to St. Augustine, it gives a perfect standard of Christian life. It has both spiritual and moral dimensions. Today, in the Gospel, we hear about judging others. Jesus says, "Do not judge so that you may not be judged. For with the judgment you make, you will be judged." These words are one of the most popular teachings of Jesus, which are most often misused. Some people use it against anyone who suggests that their actions might not be what Jesus wants. My dear brothers and sisters, when Jesus says, "Do not judge," He does not prohibit us to make moral judgments, that is, discerning what is right or wrong according to the Word of God. But what Jesus prohibits is a critical, judgmental spirit that exalts oneself while looking down on others. St. Augustine makes a beautiful comment on this Gospel. He says, "The Lord in this passage warns us against rash and unjust judgment. He wants us to act with a heart single and intent on God alone, because there are many things about which it would be rash to pass judgment on, since we do not know with what kind of a heart they are done. For the most part, those who readily judge and condemn are those who love to find fault and to condemn rather than to reprove and correct. And this is the vice of pride or envy." My dear brothers and sisters, let us look at the life of Jesus. He never condemned anyone. And this is very evident in the incident of the woman who was caught in adultery. He did not judge her, but lovingly opens a new life for her. This is what is expected of us too from Jesus. If He is slow to judge others, who are we to judge our brothers and sisters? He knows us not just externally but internally as well. However, He still shows us His mercy and opens life for us and does not push us to eternal death even though we deserve it. Let us also be merciful and people who bring life, not death, to others. Amen.